Hey guys, it's Taylor, and today I'm going to be doing my December favorites, and obviously, it's still a little early, I guess you could say, to be doing a favorites video, but I kind of had these favorites from, like, November, but I just kind of combined, it was too late to really do a November favorite, so I thought I'd just do a December one in the middle of December. It's fine. All my favorites are divided up into, like, beauty products, and then movies and books, and fashion, and yeah, I haven't really done a favorites video, I think, since June, so I have a lot of different products to show you, and I'm really excited. We're going to start off with makeup, and I have two makeup favorites, and you've seen all of these, both of these products, I guess, like, a bajillion times on my channel, so obviously I would create them, put them in my favorites video, because they are my favorites. Okay, first off, we have the Maybelline The Rocket Volume Express Mascara by Maybelline. It just looks like this. It's in that, like, purplish bottle. You probably have all seen it at Target or any other drugstore. And the reason I love this mascara so much is because it is not waterproof, by the way, but which is kind of good because with swimming, I do take my makeup off before, and it comes off easily, so that's nice. But this is just the wand. I always do this, but I realize you guys probably, my camera doesn't autofocus, so it probably isn't going to help you see it, but this is what it looks like. I just like it because it does make your lashes have a ton of volume, but they still make it long. So it's really nice because you have elongated lashes and they're thick. So I really like this. And I do like this better than the mascara I said I did liked in June, because I know that one was like a double-sided one, and I really like this way better than I do the other brand, whatever that was. Other makeup favorite I have is the Maybelline as well, Color Tattoo 24-hour like leather eyeshadows. And again, these are just in a pot. If you have not seen my channel before, it's like in a little pot like this, and you just use like your ring finger and you blend on your eyelids. You blend it on your eyelids, and that's what I have on now. I don't know if you can see it that well because the lighting's a little weird in here, but that's what I have on. And I love this so much because it stays on for a really long time. It's a really great base, especially when you want to add any other eyeshadow. It just works really, really well. So I love this. I think it's $6, but it seems like it's going to last a while, so I would definitely invest in this. They have a wide range of colors, so you can get like glittery ones or matte ones like this. And my mom loves it too. My mom got a couple of these. So anyone can really wear this. The product I have is skin related, and it's the Neutrogena Oil Free Moisturizer for Sensitive Skin, and it's just in this white bottle. Again, I also got this from Target. So Target's pretty much your one-stop shop for anything. And that's pretty much, I go to Target at least once a week. It's pretty insane. I love this because it is winter. It is swim season. My skin is super dry. And it drives me insane because whenever I do put makeup on, you can kind of see it, you know, because my skin is dry. However, this has helped immensely with trying to, like, even out my skin. It just makes it really nice. The next category I have is fashion. And for that, I have three different things I'd like to show you. The first one being this sweater. And it is actually, surprisingly, from Gap, which I know, like, no one my age goes to Gap. But I went with my mom to buy her clothes, and I actually found it. Again, you probably won't be able to see it that well, but I'm going to try to stand up and show you. So it just kind of looks like this. It's a plain maroon sweater, and it kind of tapers. It's longer in the back and, like, shorter in the front, but not too short. It still covers my entire stomach. The back is just longer. I really, really like it because it's thick and it's warm, but it's also a really, really pretty color, and I just really like it a lot. So I really enjoy this. I don't know how much it was. Gap can be a little expensive, but, you know, it's okay. So, fashion thing I have isn't really fashionable, I guess, but I wear it a lot anyway, and you've seen it if you've been watching Vlogmas, and I'll link my latest Vlogmas down below. But yeah, it's this hat, and I got this, again, from Target, and I think I've seen them out, so I still have them. I haven't seen any of the white ones left, but they have multicolored ones. And I wear this every day after swim practice because it keeps my I put this on after practice to keep my head warm. Usually I put my hair down so it still has like chlorine and stuff in it, but just so it'll dry. And I put this on top of my head to keep it a little bit warmer. And it's super comfortable and I love it a lot, and everyone says I look cute in it. Probably as a joke, but I'll take it. So this is from Target. I think it was like $7 or $8, but I'm not 100% positive. The next fashion item I have is my Converse, and they're just plain black All-Star Converse, and I love them so much. And I like these because they're still tennis shoes, but they're really comfortable, and they look way better than me wearing my running shoes, because like freshman year, I'd only wear running shoes, and that doesn't look good, especially with jeggings, so I've morphed into Converse. The next favorite I have is one movie favorite, and I don't actually have the movie, but I have like the book cover or book version of the movie, and that is Gone Girl by Gillian Flynn, and she wrote both the book and the screenplay, and I absolutely love this movie. It was so good. I'm so excited to read the book because I really wanted to read the book before I watched the movie, but that just didn't happen, and we only had time over Thanksgiving break, so I watched the movie first. But I know I'm going to love the book just as much because it was such a well put together movie. Basically, this book's about a man named Nick, and his wife Amy goes missing on their 5th anniversary, and it pretty much is like, it's a psychological thriller because you don't really know what really happened because you feel like Nick is innocent, but then he does all this stuff and it makes him look really guilty, and it just is back and forth thing, and it's so, so good. But yeah, I haven't read the book. I'm starting that soon. So yes, the movie was amazing, and it was based off of a town in St. Louis where I'm from, so it's pretty cool to see that they actually filmed in, you know, the Missouri area. Now on to my actual book favorite. I have one book favorite this month, and it is Harry Potter and the Deathly Hallows, because what book video isn't complete without mentioning Harry Potter? I picked this book up around a week ago. Oh, I'm ashamed of myself for doing that. I'm really sorry. It had to be done. Okay, I picked this up a week ago, and I read it all in a week. It was insane because I started rereading Harry Potter in May, and my goal was to get through in 1 year, and I was flying through the books. And then school started in August, and I read The Half-Blood Prince until like 2 weeks ago. So it took me a really long time to read that book. I think it's always been The Half-Blood Prince that I've had a rough time getting through. I think it's just because The Order of the Phoenix is so long that right when you get through it, you just don't want to read Harry Potter anymore. And then you realize you have to because you have to get through the next two books. And then Half-Blood Prince just takes you a while to get back into it. And then Deathly Hallows, you just want to know what happens. So I finished this. It was amazing, as always. Who doesn't love the Deathly Hallows or Harry Potter in general? There's something I was going to say about it. Oh, yes. Obviously, I'm not going to, like, give away this because if you haven't read it, like, what are you doing with your life? But I'm going to be filming a video pretty soon about my top 14 books of 2014, and I'm super excited because I've so far this year I've read 59 books, which is insane. I didn't think I could do it, but yeah, I'm really excited to film that video, and yeah, that's basically it. Harry Potter and the Deathly Hallows. Read the series. If you have not picked up the first book, or you've picked up the first book and think it's boring, hold out hope. It gets so much better. I love Harry Potter so much. So basically, those are all my favorites for December. It's a pretty short and quick video, I guess. Probably not short at all, but I was really excited to film it. I hope you guys enjoyed it, and until next time, I'm Taylor. Bye!